The other day when I was doom scrolling on my phone, I came across a video of people playing flash paper. When I looked it up, the chemistry behind nitrocellulose, which is the actual name for flash paper, it is basically just a nitrated version of cotton. And it can be easily made by nitrating cellulose-based material with an appropriate nitrating mix. And just a moment later, I think I found the perfect cellulose source, a pair of panties. But just to be sure, I looked on Google for panties MSDS and confirmed that their panties is actually 100% cotton, which would be perfect as a source of cellulose. So I decided to give it a try on nitrating my wife's panties and see if I can reproduce the result I saw in the video. Okay, so let me first go over the material needed for this experiment. Firstly, you will need a pair of panties. If you have a wife, kindly borrow it from her. Or if you don't have one, just buy one online. I mean, buy a pair of panties, not a wife. Secondly, you will need 98% sulfuric acid. While a drink opener could work, the result may not be as good. We have distilled 98% sulfuric acid from drain opener in a previous video, so anyone who needs it can refer to that video. Thirdly, you will need 68%. Oh no.
Hi, this is Funny Business Chemical Company. How can I help you today?
Hi, I would like to get a bottle of nitric acid.
Do you mean nitric acid?
Yes, nitric acid. Thirdly, we will need 68% nitric acid. I will show you how to make it in a future video, but for the time being, I will use the store-bought version of it. And the last chemical we need is baking soda. It is required for the neutralization process. Okay, so we got everything we need now. Let's begin the experiment. The first preparation step we need to do is to weigh the panties on a scale. This step is required for calculating the acid needed to complete the nitration, and also for yield calculation. For the panty we use, it weighs about 28.7 grams. From my experience, the best acid mix ratio to use is about 1 gram of cotton to 10 ml of nitric acid. So in this case, we'll be using 285 ml of concentrated nitric acid. And nitric acid to sulfuric acid ratio will be 1 to 1.75. So 500 ml of concentrated sulfuric acid will be used. This recommended ratio is experimentally determined by my previous experiments. There are many more factors that can contribute to the nitration result, and many more different combinations can be used. However, this is beyond the scope of this video. The third preparation step is to prepare an ice bath to cool down the nitration. Some of you may see guides online nitrating cotton with the use of ice bath, but this will easily lead to runaway nitration, which will release a deadly amount of nitrogen dioxide in an uncontrollable fashion. Also, good temperature control in a nitration is the key for good texture and yield in the final product, so please do not omit the use of an ice bath. When everything is ready, start mixing nitrating acid by adding sulfuric acid to nitric acid. This process will produce a lot of heat and acid fumes, so be sure to do it in a well-ventilated area or in a fume hood with proper PPE. Measure the temperature of the acid with thermometer or thermocouple and let it cool to below 15 degrees Celsius. When the acid reaches 15 degrees Celsius or below, the panties is added to nitrating mix. You should see a rise in temperature as nitration proceeds. And in hindsight, adding whole panties to acid mix at once is a very, very stupid idea. I forgot to mention the other condition that will also trigger a runaway nitration, which is adding the cellulose too quickly, and you can now see the accident for yourself. As for how to deal with this situation, I would simply suggest you to run, unless you have a very powerful film hood that can contain the accident well enough, which is what happened in my case. I fully lowered the sash and rarely turned on the fan to full power in order to fence the toxic nitrogen dioxide. The runaway nitration of nitrocellulose is relatively tame and only releases copious amounts of toxic fumes. If it is something else such as nitroglycerine, please run away at full speed, as it is very likely to explode. I waited for about 10 minutes for the runaway nitration to fully calm down, cleaned up the mess, and restarted the experiment. This time, I will be scaling down the experiment, as nitrating the whole panties at once will only lead to disaster. I cut down two pieces of the panties and placed them into the acid mix while monitoring their temperature. You should keep stirring the nitrating mix every 5 minutes or so to ensure an even mix of acid, or you can do so by using a stirrer. A simple chip stirrer will also do the job, as heating is not required. You also need to monitor the temperature closely, especially in the first 10 minutes of the nitration. This is to ensure the nitration didn't turn into runaway nitration, just like what happened. I will leave this nitration mixture under stirring for 2 hours for the nitration to complete. In the meantime, let me tell you the story of the accidental discovery of nitrocellulose. The year was 1845. A German-Swiss chemist, Christian Friedrich Schönbein, occasionally do chemistry experiment at home in the kitchen without his wife's approval. One day, an accident happened. He spilled nitric acid and sulfuric acid all over the kitchen table. Instead of using something to neutralize the acid, he reached out to the nearest cloth, which was his wife's apron, to clean up the mess. He then proceeded to hang the apron on the stove door to dry it. And guess what happened next? Yes, his wife was mad. And no, I'm just trolling. The document didn't mention his wife's reaction. In fact, the apron spontaneously ignited upon drying and burned so quickly that it seemed to disappear. So I guess his wife would wonder where the apron went instead. And this is the story of how nitrocellulose was discovered. Unfortunately, by coincidence, two more chemists independently discovered the process in the same year. And Schönbein wasn't the first chemist to publish the process despite his discovery. To this date, sulfuric nitric acid mix is still one of the major methods employed in the production of nitrocellulose. Okay, enough of story time. Let's get back to the experiment. And by this time, the nitration should be completed. Carefully remove the panties, add them to the water to quench the reaction, and slowly pour the acid mix to the ice bath. The panties is first rinsed with running tap water for 5 minutes. It's then rinsed with bicarbonate solution to neutralize the acid until no visible reaction is observed. Then proceed to rinse 5 more minutes with running tap water. After all the rinsing, test the water in the beaker with litmus paper or pH paper to ensure everything is neutralized. After the product is completely neutralized, proceed to dry the product. It is first dried by using paper towel to soak off the excess water, then dried on a hot plate at 80 degrees Celsius for 12 hours. Final product after drying will look and feel like normal fabrics with yellow tint on it. After drying, weigh the panties on scale to obtain the final mass. We got 9.932 grams of nitrated panties, which is a 68% increase in mass. However, the yield percentage isn't straightforward in the case of nitrocellulose, and the nitration reaction don't usually go to completion. The determination of nitrogen content in nitrocellulose is a very complicated topic. I'll leave the discussion for another video. For now, we can evaluate the nitrocellulose based on its burning performance. Burning the whole piece at once could set something on fire, so let me just cut a small piece of the nitro panties and test it out. As you can see, it burns very quickly and leaving almost no residue. Wow, brilliant.
Hey honey, did you see my panties?
Oh shit.